Hi, and welcome to another episode of Hot Takes with me, the Silver Fox. The Fondler is in more trouble than he even realises. This is certainly something that would never have happened if Nicola Sturgeon was running the party. But now, you're even getting mainstream media calling him a liar. His position is completely now untenable. He must go. He must resign. He must be fired. He must go. He had an appearance on BBC Scotland and he decided that running away and hiding was the better thing to do. He does not want to face scrutiny. He does not want to be out in public. And yet he is a minister of state. He, of course, is entirely a public figure. He should be there. He should be answering questions. Meanwhile, the NHS, which is his direct responsibility, is failing. We've got a video coming up on that next after this one. And the reason is, of course, that he is completely focused on his own inner turmoils and problems. He's not doing his job. And if he's not capable of doing his job, he shouldn't be doing it. He needs to be replaced. And he needs to be fired. The trouble is, Humza Yousaf cannot do that. Kendall doesn't have the balls to fire his best chum. And so you're left with an inept, stupid, corrupt, lying thief running a department badly because he's not giving it entirely is all attention. He's not giving it any attention. He's simply sitting there in the seat crying about what he's done and how he now appears to be Scotland's biggest wanker. Blaming your children for your own issues is pretty low. We'll take a look at this. But it is an astonishing thing that, like I say, even the press now are just calling him a liar. Sturgeon would never have let that happen. Here goes. So this is from his speech. This image here is his speech from yesterday. Let me pull that up so you can see him. That was him doing his speech yesterday and looking, oh, look at me. Pulls out onion, creates tears. I'm sad. Don't go. Tears don't, but don't give a shit if you're sad. I don't care. All it means is you're a sad thief, a sad liar. You've been caught. And ultimately, that's why you're sad. Lying, Michael Matheson's position now untenable as he dodges BBC appearance. So not only is he a liar and a thief, he's also a craven coward who cannot and dare not answer questions on this matter. Surely, even Kendall must fire him now. The Health Secretary is facing more mounting pressure to resign after admitting his parliamentary device had been used by his children on holiday. There's nothing. He's got to go. Under pressure, Michael Matheson refused the chance to explain himself further in relation to the iPad scandal engulfing the SNP government, as he was told his position was untenable after he lied about data usage. Well, he lies about so many things, so why not? But anyway, the Health Secretary is facing increasing calls to resign after it's emerged his claim about an 11,000 bill racked up while on holiday in Morocco had not been entirely for constituency work, as he claimed. And not just as he claimed verbally, but as he claimed on his expenses, making it a fraudulent claim and therefore he's a thief. And as I said before, it doesn't matter that he's repaying that now. That doesn't negate the fact that he still claimed it in the first place and that the crime occurred. Simply paying it back is something you're going to have to do anyway. You're still going to pay for the crime. In a tearful statement to Holyrood, presumably because if he's tearful and crying, we'll all feel sorry for him. Note, we don't. Why should we feel sorry for him? He tried to defraud the taxpayer, so screw him. This was on Thursday. He admitted the device had been used by his children as a hotspot to watch football matches while abroad. Well, since it's only that, then he'll have no problem at all handing it over just to have it fully examined, just to make sure that's all it was. And if it is football matches, oh, well, okay, it's football matches. As he said, that's fine. Let's move on. I mean, obviously, he has to still go, but let's move on. But if it's something more than football matches, then it does kind of explain the reticence he has in handing it over. The last thing he wants to do, isn't it? Anyway, despite admitting that he had known this for a week, he had reiterated to the press just on Monday that it had not been used for personal use, even though now he claims he did know. So he was lying again. Lies heaped upon lies heaped upon lies. He's even confusing himself with what lies he expects people to believe. Humza Yousaf is also facing questions over the timeline of events after backing Mr. Matheson to the hilt. This was on Wednesday, as he tried to shut the story down. And yes, he said, no, I'm drawing a line under it. That's the end of that. And of course, no, no. Just because Hamza Youssef wants it gone doesn't mean it's gone. Far from it. Hamza Youssef has got no authority anyway, has he? Certainly not over me. Anyway, the Falkirk West MSP, who claimed he had kept quiet to protect his family. Oh, yes, I'm keeping quiet to protect my family. And then picks up children and hurls them under the bus. Great father. Was invited onto Good Morning Scotland on BBC Radio Scotland to answer questions. But he told the station he had nothing more to add. He ran away and hid, like the craven coward he is. Scottish Conservative Deputy Leader Megan Gallagher did appear on the show. And while she expressed some sympathy with Mr. Matheson, she believes it is time for him to resign. She said, I understand why any parent would want to protect their children. Well, it was hardly protecting his children by throwing them under the bus, but hey, you know. He said, but I think we need to look at the timeline of events here. Last Thursday, the story about the expenses emerged and Michael Matheson told the media that the data was for parliamentary usage. Then on Monday, he was asked again by journalists if the device was for personal use. And he said, no. And now we know that this was a lie. He lied to the press. He lied to the public because the data had been used by family members. The story has changed significantly, she said. He knew about his family members using the data last week, but failed to mention anything to the media or the public when questioned. Well, of course he won't. He can't. He's got a story. He's got to stick with it because he's a liar. He can't be caught in his own lies. Only now, of course, he has. Multiple times. Multiple lies. Continual. It's the SNP way. Not only, she says, does that call into question Michael Matheson's integrity, it also calls into the First Minister's integrity. She added, I do believe that Mr. Matheson's position is now untenable because he admitted lying to the public and the press and also putting in a fraudulent claim and therefore thieving, a thieving bastard. Also, not doing his job. This is on top of the fact that the NHS is collapsing around him, that waiting lists are getting longer, that A&E waits are so long now that hundreds of people a year are dying, that it's already one of the worst waiting periods since January this year, and it's still only the beginning of autumn. Wait till winter comes. It's going to get so much worse. That's another reason he needs to go. He's not even good at his job. He's inept. Scottish Labour MSP Paul O'Kane said it was important to have a health secretary who was focused on the crisis facing the NHS this winter, just said. When asked by host Martin Gessler if it would be better for the NHS to let the story die, he responded, Michael Matheson hasn't been focused on the issues that matter in terms of his brief. There are a number of challenges in our NHS. One in seven Scots is on a waiting list, and the impending winter crisis isn't going to help, is it? But for this week and last week, and certainly for longer than that, we presume he's been focused more on these issues and not on his day job. Well, of course. Of course, he's more interested in keeping the job that he's failing to do. And look at him. Loser. Absolute loser. And also, what a terrible father. As well as being a liar and a thief and an inept fool. He needs to go. He needs to resign. He needs to go and sort out his family life. Get on his bended knees and beg his wife's forgiveness for being such a complete wanker. And then begin to patch up the relationship with the children that he has so obviously dumped on. Big time. He's not fit for office. He's not fit to be a minister. He's not fit even to be an MSP. He needs to leave politics altogether. I'm coming up. He cannot be allowed to get away with it. He must continually face the music. The only way it stops is he repays every damn penny. And he resigns both as a minister and, I think, as an MSP. Certainly at the next election, he's done, he's gone, he's finished. Nobody will vote for a lying thief. And certainly, I think, the one thing that's really alienated him amongst most people, even within SNP supporters, I suspect, is the fact that he was so willing and ready to hurl his children into the front line and hide behind his children. That's not what a man does. Man protects his children. The man takes the blame. The man takes the fall. Doesn't throw his children out in front of him. Thank you very much for watching. I hope this has been illuminating, and I hope you agree with me that it's time for Matheson to pack up his bags and hit the road. Till next time, stay safe, stay well. Do please hit the subscribe button and goodbye.